This is the SAP Developer News for January 16, 2025.
SAP Build Apps has just released a new flow function that lets you upload documents to the BTP Document Management Service, the Document Information Extraction Service, or any service that requires a binary upload. Ming Ko, a developer at SAP Build Apps, created the HTTP Destination Request Flow function, which takes a multi-part request body and lets you specify a destination, both of which enable you to upload to the services. He has written two blogs, one on using it with DMS and one on using it with docs. But I want to point out that I've just released three short videos on how to use this flow function with Build Apps and DMS. And I've released an entire application that lets you navigate through a DMS repo. So it will list all the documents in the root or any folder in the DMS repo, let you upload documents, let you create folders, and let you delete folders and documents. All you need to do is attach your destination to your DMS repo. And I want to point out that we also have a playlist dedicated just to the document management service. It has videos on setting up DMS unrelated to SAP Build, as well as how to use it with process automation and Build Apps. Links to all of that content are in the description.
While most of us were taking some time off over the holiday period recently, the CAP team has kept on working and put out another regular monthly release. That's the December 2024 release. As usual, there are plenty of highlights, some of which I want to bring to your attention here. There are so many I've actually got to list. I'm going to read through, got some notes. And this also sees CAP Node.js at 8.6 and CAP Java at 3.6. Okay, so what have we got? There are changes and improvements in the CDS language and compiler area. Specifically, for example, a completely rewritten CQN specification using TypeScript declaration files, which in turn brings about improved documentation and also some IntelliSense operations that are also improved. There's a new beta feature where foreign key elements of managed associations can be explicitly annotated. Moving to the Node.js flavor of CAP specifically, there are new compiler-related lifecycle events. They're also in beta. There are some enhancements to CDS.env. These enhancements relate to source formats and profile-specific env files. And CDSQL has some enhancements. And these enhancements bring about a more robust operation in general and also some new functions for CQN object construction. In the OData arena, there are also some additions and improvements relating to the OData containment feature and also a move to allow query option-based provision of function parameters, which some of you, I'm sure, will enjoy. In the Java flavor of CAP, there are some important changes in the area of NPM build plugin support. And also the new Khaleesi plugin for the document management service is now open source. Last but not least, in the tools area, there are many enhancements to the CDS REPL. Some of you may have seen these enhancements sort of take shape over the course of the first six episodes of The Art and Science of CAP, a live stream series that we ran recently with the one and only Daniel Hutzel. So I'll put a link to that also in the description to this item, as well as the link to this December 2024 CAPIA release notes. But also, for TypeScript developers out there, you can now just use CDS Watch to start the server, and it will automatically detect a TypeScript project, and under the hood, it'll run CDS TSX for you. There's also more, even more, in this December 2024 release, but I'll leave it to you to go and check out the release notes in CAPIA. Until then, see you online.
Hey friends, Rich Heilman here. I just wanted to stop in a bit and let you know about the Joule ABAP Developer Capabilities Early Adopter Program for customers and partners. That's right. Do you want to check out the bleeding edge technology helping ABAP developers become more efficient developers? If so, then go to the influence.sap.com site and register for the Early Adopters Program. Registration started on January 15th and will end on February 15th, the same day we plan to release to customers. So again, if you are ready to get your hands dirty with AI and using Joule within ADT to help you with ABAP development, then please sign up for this excellent opportunity to try it out, give us some feedback, and make the product better for all. Thanks, ABAP developers, and we'll see you soon. Bye for now.
You might have noticed that when a field is defined as read-only for updates in a draft-enabled application, it cannot be edited after an initial value is provided. Andrew Fisher, in his latest blog post, explains how to achieve the editing of such fields in draft using the dynamic feature control option. For this, just replace the statement read-only update with features instance in your behavior definition. Then in your behavior implementation method, verify whether an active instance of the entity already exists. If yes, the field will be made read-only. However, if no active instance exists, the field will remain editable. Please note that this is applicable only when an object is being created as a draft and has not yet been persisted. Check out the details and sample code in the blog post link provided in the description.
Hi, everyone, and welcome to the SAP Developer News. We have some updates in the Fiori and UI5 area that we want to point your attention to. First of all, the SAP Fiori Innovation Day happens on February 5th in Silicon Valley. Definitely check it out if you're in the area. AI is going to be a hot topic. There's going to be a partner session, hands-on sessions, and an outlook from the Fiori team on what's to come in the future. Check out the link to register in the description of this video. And also related to Fiori, more UI5, the 2025 roadmap is out now. Go check it out if you're interested in UI5. There's some interesting items on there, and go follow. All right, check it out. Hope to see you soon. Bye.